If you treat voice, for instance, with the same priority as web browsing, well, voice is very sensitive to delays. If you have delays greater than 100 milliseconds, you have people starting to talk on top of each other. Now, if you wait 500 milliseconds for a web page download, you're not going to notice the difference. So those are the tricks that we use in network management in order to be able to smooth out the traffic so we don't have to over-provision for peaks. And that's at risk here. If it takes more effort and there's more uncertainty in the U.S. wireless market, we're not going to be the bleeding edge deployers of these wireless technologies. They will not want to risk it because of regulatory uncertainty. So we have to make it clear, we have to make the rules as general as possible if we're going to be the leaders in the deployment of wireless technologies. Otherwise, they're going to go to Europe, they'll go to Korea or China, mm-hmm. instead of the U.S. being the leader. That is one of the frustrating things about the network neutrality debate, is there are so many hypotheticals. And oftentimes these hypotheticals are extreme situations that, I don't think they're going to be that dumb. But they bring up these extreme possibilities, and we need regulations now even though they don't exist. Neither does the technology exist or the applications exist, but we need the regulations now. So it's very frustrating.